It's Copycat Friday. You'll love it. You'll love it. It's Copycat Friday. You'll love it. Here we recreate effects from famous films and music clips, break down their stuff and show you how to do it too.
Hey, I'm back, I like to be back. Ooh. Hey, I'm back, I like to be back. Ooh. Hey, I'm back, I like to be back. Ooh. Hey, I'm back, I like to be back.
Copycat Friday, you'll love it. Copycat Friday, you'll love it.
Welcome to Copycat Friday, guys. My name is Jordy for CineCam.net, and you might have seen the Kanye West and Lil Pump collab already. Now, I personally love the clip itself. It has this amazing cartoon look, and the set looks simple and clean. The song or the lyrics are not that clean though. And that's something that I'm not a big fan of, but I guess it's freedom of speech? If you haven't seen the music video yet, be warned that the language is pretty filthy. But that's not why we're here. As a filmmaker, I always look at nice visual effects or cinematography. And in the clip, I love it, we can see this infinite long hallway, which we are going to recreate. But first up, a big shout out to our sponsor, Videoblocks. Stock clips, transitions, After Effects, templates, and more. Their growing library offers unlimited downloads for a single price per year. Here's a title sequence that I got from Videoblocks, which is an After Effects file. I can change the text to my desire, render it out, and it's ready for my project. To check it out yourself, make sure to click the first link in the description below.
Guys, we've got some exciting news!
I'm back!
Janik is back!
Woohoo!
So, Janik, how was your vacation?
Very warm, very good, but I'm glad to be back.
And lots of rice with curry sauce, I've heard.
But they were delicious.
Ah, that's nice. Now let's get back to work!
Woo!
But first, guys, a good old-fashioned... Janik! Catch!
Oh, no! I caught it.
Janik, you're way too wide. You have to turn, Janik. Okay. You have to turn around.
Okay. Still doesn't work.
Stop pushing me.
Come here, huh? Since the hallway is going to be created inside After Effects, you can basically choose any kind of texture that you can use as the walls and the ceiling. But it is best that you actually make that picture yourself of a wall that you like or something. We've just designed this wall right here, which kinda resembles the same wall as they used in the music video. After you've got your picture of a wall or a wall texture that you can find on the internet, we're going to import it into Photoshop. If you like, you can add some extra elements to your wall in here. We actually painted over our LED lights as they weren't strong enough, so we simply added these rectangle shapes over them and added a glow to it. Now, what you want to pay attention to is that the wall texture can be tiled. In other words, if we place two of these textures next to each other, they should seamlessly match. Having these LED strips makes that easier for us as we can just cut on that point. So, what I'm gonna do is press Ctrl-A or Command-A for the Mac users to create a selection field. Then go up to Menu, choose Select Transform Selection. Adjust the selection area so that it only covers the wall. Then hit Return on your keyboard and head back to the menu. Image Crop. As you see, on the right side of the texture, I cut half into the light bar. And on the left side of the texture, I again cut away half of that light bar. When we tile this image, it will seamlessly fit together. Now, if you would search for pattern texture or something on Google, you can already find images that you can use straight away without going into Photoshop. We've got everything here except for a recording room, so that's why we're transforming the bathroom into a recording room with Arlex foam to absorb all the echoes and the sound. Awesome! And what do you think about our recording studio, Lorenzo?
It looks so professional.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah.
actual shot of you and your buddy dancing has to be done in front of a green screen. Green screens are not that expensive and they can be used for many visual effects. It's definitely something that I would recommend to have in your equipment collection. And if you'd like to see what we use, well then you can find a link to all the gear in your description below. So anyways, make sure that the green screen connects to the floor and that it's evenly lit. The camera sits on a tripod and this will make the whole process in After Effects easier. Plus, we can create a virtual camera motion later on. Or you can walk forward if you like or just stand still. If you walk around though, then pay attention to the lighting and that you stay within the green screen. The actual music video was shot a little bit different. They actually built a small hallway and with a blue key in the back, they expanded it in post-production. But building such a set was not really possible for us, definitely not in 3 days. Anyways, let's fire up After Effects because we got our shot and the texture of the wall. We're going to start with the infinite hallway. Create a new composition and drag your wall texture in there. From the layer options, enable 3D for that picture. You can then take the rotation tool from the toolbox and turn the picture 90 degrees around. And this is easily done by holding down the Shift key as you do so. Then with the layer selected, press Ctrl or Command D twice. By pushing on the Z axis or that blue arrow, you can offset that picture to the side. Then do the exact same thing for the next wall, but push it to the other side. The ceiling needs to be turned around first, so with the rotation tool again, turn it on the X axis. Again, hold down the Shift as you do so. You can now go ahead and position the ceiling to make it fit better with your walls, but make sure to always push on those axes. Next, go into the menu, select Layer, New, Camera, and from the presets, try to take something that matches with the lens that you shot your green screen on. In our case, that was 24mm. And again, hit OK. And this is that virtual camera that I was talking about before. Now, unfortunately, we cannot animate on this virtual camera because we're mixing 2D and 3D together. The reason I am creating it, though, is to have a natural perspective of the hall. As you saw in our intro, we had multiple shots. Some were captured with a 35mm lens. So in After Effects, I would also set my virtual camera to that focal length. Now that hallway is not infinite yet, so let's go into the effects library and search for CC Reptile. Drag that one to the walls and increase the expand right and left a bunch. And this will tile and expand that texture. When you're done, copy that effect, select the two other layers and paste it. Now all three sides are expanded. We're still left with a little gap in the back and unfortunately we can't tile the texture infinite, so here's a little workaround for that. Select all of your three walls, hit Ctrl C to copy them and then Ctrl V to paste. Then hit the R key to open up the rotation property of all the three duplicates. What you want to do now is offset the rotation a tiny bit so that they turn inwards. And this is going to be only 3 degrees, so abstract by 3 or add 3 depending on your left or right wall. See that they point inwards. Then right-click on those layers and choose Pre-compose. And this will group them all together, but we're going to have to enable 3D for that layer as well, and I'm also going to enable to parse through the position properties. And that way After Effects knows which position that the layers have within that comp. Now just simply push that pre-comp to the back on the Z-axis until it fits within that gap, making the illusion that there's an infinite hole.
$20 if I can do a kickflip, Jenny.
Kick it!
$20 it is. Let's do this! Yeah! Woo! Yes! No! I got it! $20!
The next step is pulling the green key. So create a new composition in which you want to drag your clip. With the key light effect, you can remove the green. Our green screen shot has a reflection in the floor, but it's not a big problem if you can key that out too. We are now left with a little dark line from where the green screen touches the floor. And this can easily be removed with an effect called CC Simple Wire Removal. Make sure that this effect sits above the key light effect. Click on the Point A tool and place it on the left side of your green screen. Then select the Point B tool and place it on the right. These two points now define a wire or thin line that you want to remove. Then just play around with the thickness, slope, and mirror blend until your line is soft. Going back now to the previous composition, in here we are going to drag in the comp of the green screen shot. Like before, enable 3D for that layer. We don't need to offset the position anymore since we already filmed this from a higher angle. But you can of course push it on the axes to bring it better in place or to pull it closer to the camera. Now because of the three-dimensional walls, at a certain point they will come in front of the two-dimensional clip. And that's why you'll still see the surrounding. No worries, with the clip selected, take the pen tool from the toolbox and draw a mask. You'll have to go with the walls, but these are straight lines, so that's not so hard. Inside the green screen, you can place your mask roughly. and that should place you better within that three-dimensional hallway. And now there is still a big part of the floor that needs to be filled in. We want to reuse our floor, so you could either film an empty shot from the same angle or cut a piece from the floor in that existing clip. Let's go for that one. The composition of your green screen shots, you can make a copy of that in your project panel. Name the other one floor or something. Open it up and draw a rectangle mask over the floor. Add the reptile effect to it, expand it, and increase the blend borders. This, however, will leave a small gap between each tile, which is because of that mask. But again, no worries, we can fix that. First, increase the feather of that mask, which will actually make it worse. But still, don't worry. Duplicate the clip in your comp and move the one on the bottom down until all of those gaps are filled up. And what we've just created is a texture of our actual floor. But because we already have the right perspective, we can just go ahead and place that onto the bottom of our composition, and that's it. You can reposition it a little if you like, for example, to match it up better with the crack in the floor. We've actually just cheated a little bit because in the back, the perspective isn't too good. But because we stand in front of that, nobody will notice it. We're almost there, and this is definitely our longest copycat ever. Sorry for that, but I'm hoping that you're learning also a ton of new things. The end of the green screen clip is still visible, so I'm going to draw a rough mask around that line. It won't do much because this is the second mask that has been applied to that clip. So within the layer properties, I'm going to set the blending of that second mask to subtract. And now we can feather it to remove that line. Finally, we want to add some travel to that shot. And like I said before, we cannot animate that virtual camera because of the 3D and 2D mix. So what I'm going to do is simply select everything, right-click and choose Precompose. Scale this precomp up and start animation for it. Then move forward in time and decrease the scale. And now it seems like the camera is traveling backwards as me and Janik are walking forward. And that's how you can place yourself into a virtual infinite hallway. Now I'm tired of all the yapping now, so thank you for watching. Thank you, Videoblocks, for the support. Make sure to check out their library. And like always, stay creative.
Komt dit maar goed. Nog zoveel werk. Kijk eens, het is al 10:30 en we zijn nog een paar uur zoet. Belangen nog niet klaar. Oh.